So now, the question is reversing the process of old age, and I've done my little spiel for the last two evenings. Now we'll spend half an hour or so, maybe 2 half hours. And if anyone missed the programs, you can get tapes of these programs for $25 each. 25 smackarooniums a throw, okay? And we appreciate the support for the program. There's no catch and there's no special spiel. You like the program, you support it. Send in your light bill. And if you're finding a value, you know, if it's doing something for you more than those other people, those plastic preachers, if we do something for you, then support the program. That's the only spiel you're going to get. Now, question number one, okay.
If I heard you correctly, earlier in the discussion, you mentioned that we are born into this, if I interpret it correctly, a human experience.
Right.
Relatively clean-minded, or having the opportunity, having the opportunity to experience what you're calling this possibility of not dying.
Right.
If that's the case, then it appears to me that my children, being young enough, stand a good chance of experiencing this.
Yes.
Through
you.
Me.
Yes. You're the gateway.
But what I haven't heard you say or expound on is how that is handled, realizing that our present system requires certain things of us, legally, education, etc. So how do we function within the system and be apart from the system?
Well, you know, the system is corrupt. It always was, and it always will be. And your bureaucrats and your demagogues, they'll see to it, you know, that you will not find selfhood, find independence from them. For example, if you had a pill that you put in water that could make gasoline, the gasoline companies would be against it. If you had a pill to give you perfect health, the doctors would be against it, guarantee you. And if you had a little pill to give you eternal life, the undertakers would pick it. Unfair to undertakers. See, so don't expect people who are parasites on the human condition to give up easily, because once the parasite, the temptation, the original one was in the garden, the paradise, before paradise was lost. Once life is reversed, where God is no longer the ruling love, then the spirit of the temptation embodied in man, all ambitious men and women ever since, are addicted to your failing. Their life only comes from your falling. And therefore they live like parasites. That's why they confuse you and confound you. Have you seen how your mothers sometimes confuse and confound? And you wonder, why are they so confusing? Why do they call black white, green pink? You know, I didn't say that. I said this, but you know very well they said that and not this. It's not, yeah, but I meant that, but you know very well what they meant. They confuse you and make it out because out of your reaction to their temptation and your fall, they draw their life like a parasite. And only out of the dying, you know, if you want to eat a lamb chop, you have to kill the lamb, right? There's no way you can eat a lamb chop without eating killing the lamb. It's the same thing with human beings. Unless you fall and die, you can't prey on a person that's full of light and full of faith. You'll take one bite out of you, go, see? It's not the stuff that he can live off, a light-filled person. Only when you fall, and there's an energy given off in your failing, a life that given off, that they depend on. So that maybe your parent, let's say parents are responsible in this linear order. Maybe your parent was a little child once, and a mother was dead, and the dead in her was made alive. She was made dead because she gave up her life to her parent. See, it's the way, it's a pecking order or a biting order. It's a dog-eat-dog world, we call it. But that child was a little child once, and instead of having a mother that was a princess or a prince, a father that was a prince, mother the princess, you know, each having a light shining to testify to the way of the child knows is the way, they have just the opposite. They have death as life. Their will, which is not their will at all, but the will of something on earth as it is in hell, which they've inherited, the spirit of death and the spirit of dying as if that was the spirit of life, they have that standing unholy in the place of the holy, and the child resents that. It resents the confusion, the confounding of its little realizations. Instead of being confirmed, it's confounded. See what I mean? I confirm, the other guys confound. I cause you to realize the other guys teach. And teaching is a confounding of the soul, see? You don't need anyone to teach you the truth, the Bible says. We're all born of God. Is this in the scripture? The time is coming that not every man shall say to his brother, know the Lord, but I shall write the laws in their mind, in their hearts, so I shall inscribe them. I shall be their God and they shall be my people. See? It goes on to say those things. I'm saying something outside wants to be your God, and see, and it won't let you find God, because if you do, it can't be your God. See, it has to pull you away. And the powers that be, can only go on being the powers that be by seducing you away from your selfhood, killing you with confusion, sowing doubt in your mind so that you fall and die and become subject to their domination. So they get power to that desire to dominate. And this is the order you're born into, and it's in the teachers, it's in the psychiatrists, it's in the ministers, it's in the bureaucrats. You see, the whole order of things is to kill you, to frustrate you, to upset you. Even the laws, that even you want to send your kids to school, but the schools are corrupt. But originally the laws had some meaning and value, some purpose in life. But now the schools are corrupt. You send your kids to school, and they made it mandatory to send kids to school because there used to be some parents who didn't want their kids educated. You know, there are parents just like that. They want to see them fail. They gloat over their failing, knocking other kids down, building themselves up. So they made laws mandating kids to go to school, and it wasn't so bad. Maybe it wasn't so bad in those days, but look at the schools now. Look how corrupt and insane. The more power they have, the more power they want. And what are they teaching the kids? Nothing. Look at the sex education. Look at the corruption in schools. If the teachers don't corrupt them, if the system doesn't corrupt them, the kids who are corrupted will corrupt them. Follow? So you see, they all live on each other. A kid that is corrupted in drugs will turn around and find pleasure in seeing his brother stumble and get benefits psychologically, emotionally, and financially, right? Out of that, we're living in a system of death and dying, and those who reign, who rule us, the kings and queens, the whores and whoremongers, the kingpins and the high rollers, and God knows who they are, the motivators, the manipulators, the parasites on the human condition, all of them pretending our benefit. See? Lying through that. How many times you've been told to have an operation that you didn't really need? How many people are operated on, and how many people die every year? It would fill a medium-sized city from the people who... Why did you have an operation? Why did they recommend it? Secretly, for your own good, right? Yeah, but it was known to make payments on the Mercedes. Selfish, greed, power. It's in everyone. Never mind they have a degree or collar. Question authority, all right? So you're going to have to, the question, I was on a roll there, forgive me. But the question is, you have to have the strength of your understanding and pull your kids out of school, teach them yourself, go to another state, do whatever is necessary, but get your kids out of the system. And you have to love them, and you have to be strong enough, and your love must be stronger than the lures of the world. See, if it isn't, that you struggle to say, don't do this, and it only becomes, if it's a wrong energy, if it's a will involved, if you don't have the light that they can respect and the love they can feel that touches their soul, then they'll rebel against your will with a will of their own. And you say no, they say yes. You say do, they don't. You say don't, they do. And then they get their support, the will of the world, because the support for this rebelliousness in the world is stronger, into drugs, into this. Your love must be stronger. Your powers must be stronger than the powers of the world. Thank God I've saved all my kids. Okay? And they're all quite unique, as you've noticed. And yours can be too. Okay? Now, my wife gave me a hard time, and I wasn't given a perfect woman, and thank God I wasn't, because I wouldn't have been the man I am today if, you know, if she was perfect to begin with.
Well, if I take your answer, as deep as it was, and I relate that to another earlier part of your discussion,